So the research I'm doing here at Bournemouth is about prosthetic feet. So if you see someone running with one of the feet, it is basically a spring. And understanding how that spring works and how it responds to the person who's using it is really where we're interested. So at the minute, if you or I were to lose a foot, we are prescribed a new foot governed by how much we weigh. But what we believe and what our research is showing is that you should be prescribed a different foot based on your level of activity. Because their good leg might have spent 30 years learning to run, and now it's being forced to run in a different way. What I want to do is make a tool to actually prescribe a foot which will allow symmetry once again, so the way that they used to be able to run. My background is in suspension design, so I used to work for Land Rover and Jaguar cars. Although it seems like a big leap away from suspension, prosthetic feet is exactly that. It's just suspension for people. You're trying to achieve different things. With suspension in the car, you're trying to eradicate any kind of feedback to the passengers. With a foot, actually, you're trying to make it as efficient as possible, so that means any energy absorbed by the foot is then given back to the person to spring them away from their step. For me, because the university funds it, the direction of the PhD goes exactly where I wanted to go. And also, depending on what subject you're doing and how the funding works, you often get extra budget for rigs, for fixtures, for travel. Even if it's going overseas, you can go to conferences and shows and that kind of thing, as well as a lot of training. The university itself are responsible for looking after the students when they're here. They have to support the research, they have to support the lifestyle, but what you get in addition, of course, are supervisors who are responsible just for you. There are plenty of areas that could use engineering that people often neglect, and I think the amount of research that's been done into prosthetic feet is a good example of that. The fact that I can come along here and do some fundamental research on a product that's over 20 years old suggests that people haven't been really doing their homework with it. So it's nice to be able to be a part of something that can actually make a difference to someone's life. And there's not very many places in the world who are studying prosthetic feet. In fact, it's an area of very limited research to date. And so it's great to be a part of the research here at Bournemouth. And my supervisors and the rest of my colleagues here are very passionate about all the work that we're doing.